Assalamu alaikum. I received a message from someone saying I cannot forgive myself for something that I did in the past. My brothers and sisters, Allah will forgive you. And you know what? You need to learn a lesson, move on. Subhanallah. Life should not stop because you did something in the past. Don't allow it to stop. Don't let it bother you and bug you. If you sought the forgiveness of Allah the first time you did it, sincerely, Allah forgave you. Remember that. The first time you sought the forgiveness of Allah sincerely, Allah forgave you. So now, you are just a human. Don't try and be an angel. You won't be able to. And you're not a devil because you don't defy Allah. You did something in your weakness during your bad days, perhaps at a time when you were ignorant, perhaps when you had distanced yourself from Allah. You recollected, you came, you remembered, you sought forgiveness, you changed your ways. That's it, forget about the past. Sometimes you may have to live with one or two things based on, you know, the repercussions of what you did. But Allah and His forgiveness, that's clear. Allah will forgive you and forgiveness is there. However, like I said, say for example, a person happened to do something so absurd, they chopped off their finger. I'm giving you a silly example. And Allah will have forgiven them for having done that if they did it intentionally. Absurd example, but I don't want to get into a certain example that comes to my mind. Let's hold on to this one. Allah will forgive you for having chopped off your finger, but throughout your life here, you're not going to have a finger, you see, because you chopped it off. So certain things you do, they resulted in something in your life. Allah will forgive you, but you're going to have to live with that thing that was the result of a sin that you committed. Not to say Allah is displeased with you anymore because He's forgiven you. Don't doubt that. Allah has forgiven you. Don't ever say, I can't forgive myself, because you're not the owner of forgiveness and you don't need to forgive or accept from your own self. It's Allah who actually accepts or rejects, not you. So you just have hope in Allah. Hope in Allah is an act of worship. Seeking forgiveness is an act of worship. So Allah wants us to seek forgiveness. That's why He's created us as human beings who have weaknesses. Otherwise, we wouldn't have had any weaknesses. So don't be too hard on yourself. Be the best you can. You know, there is a balance between being hard and not being hard. Sometimes you hear people saying, be as hard as you can. Some people say, don't be too hard. So you be as hard as you can in the sense that you need to know your level, your capacity. Be disciplined. But don't be so hard that you're going to crack. That's what is meant by it. So sometimes when people say, don't be too hard on yourself, they say, I won't get up for Fajr, I won't do Dhuhr, I don't have to read Quran, I don't have to obey Allah because I don't have to be too hard on myself. No. That's not what is meant by don't be too hard on yourself. You know, when you're turning to Allah and you're trying your best, but you're always sad because, you know, you think that you're not good enough. No, you are good enough. You're just a human. And you know what? You'll be surprised. Most of the human beings out there are just like you. You might have a little category that might not be as good, and you might have a little category that may be a little bit better in the sense that they may have been given some strength by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be much stronger, willpower and so many other things. But you're just a normal human being, perhaps like the rest. There might be billions just like you. And how can we have everyone thinking I'm not good enough? You're just a human. We need to know. Don't say, I cannot forgive myself. Allah has probably already forgiven you. Shaytan is the one who comes and makes you think, I can't forgive myself. What have I done here? Do you know? So don't allow that to happen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to move on. And this is why I want to say something very, very important. Don't ever remind people about their past if their past was not a good past. Don't remind them in a negative way. You know, yeah, you remember, you used to be like this and you used to... Don't do that. Treat people as they are now. You know, treat people as they treat you and as they are now. In fact, better than that. But don't ever remind people or rub it in to say, you, Oh, you have no right to talk. Look at you. You are this and you're that. No. To be honest with you, no matter who they are, if what they are saying has merit, take it. Like they say, if the cap fits, wear it. Subhanallah. Even if a drunk person is telling you, hey, you need to pray 5 times a day, is that statement true? The answer is yes. Well, then let me take it as a reminder. I don't have to say, who are you to tell me? No, Allah wanted those words to get to your ears. They got to your ears, even through a person who may not be, you know, from a certain angle, upon a certain level. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.